Welcome to Module 5 of the Master in Rotating Machinery of University of Zaragoza. During this section, 1.3, we are going to review the main difference between the most common use type of electric motors used in the oil and gas industry, the induction and the synchronous motor. Also, we will have a look to the different factors that must be studied before making the final decision about if the motor is to be an induction or synchronous motor for a new project in our facilities. Many oil and gas companies have internal standards which are based on experience or lesson learned for setting up the rating limits for selecting an induction or synchronous motor. The last slide of this presentation shows a typical selection chart. Then the question of choosing induction or synchronous motor is a common one when we are dealing with compressor drives, and the answer is not simple at all. Many factors must be taken into consideration, where the output rating is definitely one of those factors, but not the only one. Synchronous motor has some beneficial characteristics that can lead to savings in our plant during the operation. For example, synchronous motor has higher efficiency or can help us to improve the overall power factor or our facility. For the oil and gas industry, electric motors are becoming more and more critical. When we are dealing with high power motor, reliability and efficiency are two things that are carefully evaluated. Furthermore, large motors are being preferred in many cases, rather than having multiple processes, packages, performing the same function. For example, a 55 megawatt motor was built to be used in an oil and gas facility in Africa. A motor of this size will be definitely a synchronous motor. On the other hand, motors of a smaller rating, going let's say 6 to 12 megawatts, are not predefined to be induction or synchronous, and this selection is what this module will be addressing. Different starting methods need to be evaluated to satisfy the electrical network requirements and load torque curves and inertia of the load. These different starting systems also have an effect on the motor design due to the high starting current in the case of direct line starting or due to the presence of harmonics when variable speed drive are used. Okay? Here on this slide you can see selection charts depending on number of poles and the rating power of the motor. If synchronous or induction motor must be used. In the middle, there is an overlapping area where you have to check efficiency, cost of power, reactive power requirements, or starting limitation of the motor in order to decide which one to use. Well, let's remember a little bit how both motor works, induction and synchronous motor. The induction motor works by inducing current through the small air gap between the stator and the rotor. The stator current creates a rotating magnetic field in the air gap between the stator and rotor. The interaction of the induced rotor current with the rotating magnetic field generates a torque on the motor. The induction motor has the advantages of being self-regulating, which means that is capable to adjust the torque demand of the load with the output of the power. Therefore, no additional equipment is needed for regulation in the induction motor. If there is no load on the motor shaft, the rotor will go at the speed that is slightly lacks the synchronous speed. It's very close to the synchronous speed. This is the slip of the motor, the difference between the real speed and the synchronous speed. When the motor is loaded, the difference between the synchronous speed and the rotor speed increase, and the slip also increase. When a slip of the motor increase, a higher current is induced in the rotor bars, and the interaction of the two currents, the stator and the rotor, becomes stronger and the higher torque is provided to the motor load. Respect to synchronous motor. The word synchronous is originated from Greek. The prefix syn means with and chronos means time. Then synchronous motor literally operates in time with or in synchrony with the power supply system. Synchronous motor contains a rotor which rotates in synchrony with the stator magnetic field. Then there is no slip in this type of motor. Therefore, there is no induced current into the rotor because the magnetic field at the stator and the rotor are rotating at the same speed. Due to this, the rotor of the synchronous motor is excited with an external DC current to provide the rotor magnetic field. The synchronous motor cannot be started directly because they need a control associated with it. The main parts of synchronous motor are the frames, who supports and protects the motor, the stator provides a rotating magnetic field, the rotor includes the winding to create the magnetic field from the external DC current, and the exciter which should supply the magnetic current to the rotor winding. Just mention that the induction motor have the same parts except the exciter, which is something particular to the synchronous motor. Well, in this table, we can see the major difference between the induction and synchronous motor as a quick reference. We can see that induction motor has a higher starting torque compared to the synchronous one. On the other hand, the synchronous motor have more starting torque. In terms of maximum torque, both motors provide similar figures. From the point of view of thermal overload limit we stand by the motor, we can conclude that the synchronous motor is the winner, which means that it has a very solid construction. In terms of efficiency, both motors are quite efficient compared with the mechanical system, for example. Nevertheless, synchronous motors have always higher efficiency. One of the biggest advantages of the synchronous motor is that it can produce reactive power and help the system to improve the overall power factor, and we can save money because we avoid the utility penalty, okay? Other parameters are the excitation equipment, which is necessary for synchronous motor, the protection equipment, more complex in the case of synchronous motor, the control panel, which is not necessary in the case of induction motor, and finally, the cost, where we can say that synchronous motor are around 25% more expensive. Nevertheless, because of the higher efficiency, this 20% is not a key point to make the final decision. Here we can see the typical torque current curves of induction and synchronous motor. As you can see, the torque and starting current required by both types of motor are different. The induction motor type have the following main advantages. It has simple and solid construction due to the simple of electrical machines, which comprise only the stator and rotor. And in addition, the rotor consists only of simple rotor bars and is not connected to any external electric circuit for regulating, control, etc. Induction motor have a high breakdown torque, which is critical for special quadratic loads, for example, pumps. In some cases, this breakdown torque is the decisive factor in selecting this type of motor, where the alternative could be an oversized synchronous motor in order to have this high breakdown torque. The action motor, there is a very simple control panel required. For during light starting, the control panel is as simple as start and stop. In comparison with synchronous motor, no excitation panel is required. Induction motor has cheaper initial investment, which is one of the main factors in selecting an induction motor if compared to synchronous one. Okay. On the other hand, the figure on the right hand. Synchronous motor, even though more costly than the induction motor, are preferred in many cases, especially when the motor rating increases. The main reason for selecting synchronous motor are reactive power compensation is the main advantage of the synchronous motor. We can compensate reactive power to adjust the plant total power factor and avoid utility companies associated with low power factor. High efficiency is another characteristic of synchronous motor. The fact that the rotor is excited with the DC current for producing the magnetic field avoid much of the associated losses. And the other characteristic is the high starting torque and low starting current, which less impact on the electric grid.